Welcome to the Lamar Woodley Show. I'm your host.
You might as well shit.
Lamar Woodley.
And I'm your co-host, Michelle Newell. We're on the north side right now. As I told you guys before, you never know where Lamar is going to be. And today, we're on your side of the town. We have Heinz Field over there. This is kind of your turf.
Actually, when I first got here to Pittsburgh, I used to get my hair cut right here on East Ohio Street.
Oh, for real?
Got Heinz Field over here. I used to get my car washed over here. You know, I spent a lot of time here on the north side, so feels good to be back over here.
Yeah, we have the Shore Project. That's who we're going to be with today, a group of girls that we're going to be able to talk to.
Yeah, great opportunity here to, you know, here in Pittsburgh to have an opportunity to talk to some young ladies, you know, just to hear what's on their mind, join in on their group discussion.
Yeah.
It's going to be real good, real fun day today.
And I heard some of the girls even like football, so yeah, that's going to be an interesting thing for
you.
Yeah,
and then definitely coming off a big win. Mm-hmm. Now we had an opportunity to go on the West Coast, Arizona, three or four hour time difference. Mm-hmm. Now, so it set us back a little bit. But going to Arizona came off a big win.
Yeah.
You know, another guy went down. Chris Hoke went down. And Steve, mm-hmm. One of our backups, he went in there and played an excellent game yesterday. And we had an opportunity not only play against Arizona, but like Stiller West out there because a lot of Pittsburgh fans were out there. We kind of took over the stadium, and there's a lot of ex-Stiller coaches that's out there.
Yeah, I was thinking it was like a homecoming because you had ex-football coaches plus former football players.
Clark Hagan, Joey Porter, Nick Easton, all them players are out there. And some of the coaches, I wasn't here with Wiz and Hunt and all them when they was here coaching with the Steelers, but it was definitely a great feeling to go out there and come out with the win.
That's right, and you know, you never know what's going to happen on the Lamar Woodley Show. We have a special guest for you today. Tell us a little bit about the guest we have today.
You know, like you said, you never know where we're going to be. You know, so I brought one of my guests, rookie, Chris Carter.
Welcome to the show.
One of the rookie linebackers. Became good friends in training camp. You know, this guy's going to be special one day. He contributes a lot on special teams, but he's definitely going to be a great player when he get in there. And, you know, these past few weeks, he's been having an opportunity to get in there and spill some of the linebackers because we've been injured. And Chris been going there doing a great job.
You know, Chris, you're coming from L.A. and you're in Pittsburgh. How do you like the city so far?
I like it a lot. I mean, it's a lot going on. It's a big step back from L.A. as far as the speed of it all. But everybody out here is nice. I mean, me being a rookie coming in here to playing for the Steelers, you know, I get to give it a lot of the older vets like Lamar. And, I mean, they really look out for me and just make sure I'm taken care of as far as, you know, any needs that I have out here.
Now, the biggest thing is going to be the weather.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing.
How can you adjust to the weather? You never, you know, you went to Fresno State, correct?
Yeah.
You know, and it was Sunshine State. You over there, it never rains in California. And now you're here on the East Coast.
Yes.
Where you're going to deal with a little snow. How you think you're going to be able to handle that?
I mean, you just got to deal with it. It's part of the job, I guess. You come from Michigan, so I know you're used to it, but
yeah.
I'm used to seeing 80 degrees and sunny every day, so that's a big adjustment I'm going to have to make. But at the end of the day, I want to play football. I don't care what weather it's in.
I hope you're driving a truck because when it gets snowy out here, it's going to be a little rough for you.
Yeah, man, I'm going to have to get something, right?
But you enjoy your time here in Pittsburgh, right?
Yeah, I'm loving it. I mean, just the team, you know, all the teammates around me is looking out for me. I don't really get homesick or anything like that because I always got my boys. I got a lot of brothers around me. So
that's good. Yeah. That's good.
And I knew in Arizona you had about like 60 tickets because his brother actually played for the Arizona Cardinals,
who's a
defensive tackle. They had like 60, 70 family members come here for the game. Man, how was that getting all those tickets for the game? And who did they root for during that game?
It was crazy, man. It was a big family reunion,
crazy.
And big ups to my mom because she really took care of the whole ticket situation, so my brother and I wouldn't have to.
So what did your mom just have on the Steelers jerseys or Cardinals jerseys?
Oh, they went and got special shirts made, actually, just all black. And then on the front, it'd be like Cardinals. On the back, it'd be like Steelers. And then
they would,
you know, each family member, it'd be switched for both sides. Thanks.
See? You never know. See, out here
you never
Marshall,
know.
See?
So we want to thank you definitely for coming on the show, Chris. And we have so much in store for you guys out there. We'll be back. This is the Lamar Woodley Show on Wolf City TV.
Get him on camera. I got it covered right now.
Everybody get online with Lamar Woodley. Got it jumping out, singing.
Where I'm from, you got to cross the field.
Got it jumping out, singing. You ain't listening. Many out on the field, they be coming in. First quarter, got to say it all. On my Twitter fans, let me see you tweet it out. Tell them how you feel. Anything you want to talk about.
How you doing, Lamar? It's my teammate, Chris Carter.
Good to meet you.
Thanks for having us today. Are you guys
Thanks
in a meeting
coming.
Right now?
Yeah, we're just getting ready to get started.
Oh, we can join in.
So tell us a little bit about the SHORE Project. What exactly is this all about?
The SHORE Project stands for Support, Hope, Opportunity, Responsibility, and Empowerment. And those are the qualities that we are looking to help instill in the youth of Pittsburgh. Mm-hmm. And right now the biggest way we're doing that is through the Girls Mentoring Program, which, as you can see, is growing. We started a little over a year ago with three girls in this new set of girls coming through, and we obviously have a few more than that now.
So I'm kind of taking a scan of the girls right now. What's the age range?
It's from 12 years old, sixth grade, through 18, which is high school. And then we also have some 18 to 21 year olds who are in what we call our Reaching Back program. And it's sort of like a mentoring and leadership training for those girls to help start pouring into the younger girls.
Okay. So what do you young ladies like about this program?
The group, you could just basically have friends here. You get a lot of steam off. Whether you have problems, you can text them or call them, email them all through the night, whenever you have something going on with you. So basically it's just a program like, if you can't talk to your mom or somebody, you can talk to them.
This is our yak box. Everybody knows that girls like to yak. Sometimes we have trouble controlling the yak, and so this is a great way to bring up whatever questions are on everybody's mind, give a feel for what everybody wants to talk about.
I seen that on Basketball Wives.
LA
Basketball, I'm serious.
They did one in LA, the LA one.
See, everybody thought I was joking. I'm watching Basketball Wives.
All right. Ours has been around for a very long time, so.
Oh, they copied off y'all.
They took our idea. We have actually replaced our normal questions, because a lot of times we get embarrassing questions that might be about family or boys or things like that. And since we have some guys in our midst tonight, we don't want to make y'all blush. So we had the girls replace our normal questions with some questions that they have put together specifically for you.
Oh, see, I took the good questions.
And they're all anonymous, so we'll shake it up.
You should just pass it around.
Yeah.
Pass it around. Let everybody pick one.
Y'all just get one.
Pass it back. We'll get it around to everybody. Did you want one, Jamir?
What made you want to play football for the Steelers?
Oh, you know what? Actually, the Pittsburgh Steelers have been my favorite team ever since I was in the seventh grade. Doing my last year in football, I wore number 36. It was Jerome Bettis. Mm-hmm. I've been a Steeler fan ever since then, but, you know, when you're coming out for college and you're going into the draft, you don't have an opportunity to pick which team you're going to. So the Pittsburgh Steelers drafted me in the second round with the 46th pick, and it was like a dream come true. You know, being that the Pittsburgh Steelers have a great defense, great linebacker group, and I have an opportunity to be a part of it, and it's feeling good right now.
Would you let your only daughter, who is about to be 16, get a tattoo or not?
Oh, that's a good one.
Yes. I would.
Really?
Yes, I would. I mean, because, you know, sometimes people look at tattoos and they think tattoos actually define a person. I had somebody judge me one time based on my tattoos. Didn't have an idea who I was. And they looked at my tattoos and kind of identified me as something else. But really it wasn't, you know. I'd rather for my daughter to come ask me because she have a tattoo than go do it behind my back. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that just shows the trust that I have in my daughter. If she decides she want to get a tattoo, I'll let her get one because dad got a few. Ain't nothing wrong with it. We got any more? Come on, somebody give me one more. One more, I need one more.
What would you say to these young ladies about where they're going, where they could be, their education, young men, just some wisdom that you could leave with them?
I mean, I think the first thing is you got to have confidence in yourself. That's number one. You got to have confidence in yourself and not looking for anything from somebody else. Because if you don't believe in yourself, you know, who'll believe in you? And I think a lot of times people look on TV and they want to be what they see on TV. You know, a lot of that stuff is just acting most of the time. You know, a lot of people, everybody want to be the movie star, the celebrity. They want to be all that. But, you know, first you have to have success in the classroom. You know, you have to educate yourself. And don't let anyone bring you down. You know, you have a lot of people when they grow up is people constantly telling you what you can't do. You'll never be nothing in life. They'll never want to see you succeed in life. Because I had a lot of people tell me that, You know, when I was in junior high, I didn't let that stop me from getting where I wanted to go in life. You know, when those people told me that I wasn't going to do nothing, it like motivated me. You know, it was and I tell everybody this story, it was a group of friends that I used to hang with. You know, we grew up together. We were real tight, real strong, but they started going the wrong way. So I had to make a decision in my life. Do I follow them and be cool, or do I do my own thing? Because I know at the end of the day, I live my own life. And I know where I want to be 10 to 15 years from now. And by me making that decision, that's why I'm in front of y'all here today. Because I chose to let them go that way, and I'm going to go this way. You know, you control your own life. When I play football, I don't need no one to motivate me. This is what I love to do. You can talk about me, or whatever, but I motivate myself every day when I go out there on that football field. I don't look for no one else to do it, because no one else can motivate me like I can motivate myself.
Oh, look, she has a Lamar Willie jersey.
Way to represent, way to represent. Hold me down.
Thank the Shore Project so much. It was so nice talking to you ladies today. Thanks for showing us some great dance moves too.
Yeah, we had a really good time. I'd like to thank Chris Carter, my teammate, for coming out today. I'd like to thank y'all for letting me join in on the group discussion, and I enjoyed answering your questions today.
And if you want more information about the Shore Project, you can go online and get that information. This is the Lamar Woodley Show, and you're watching Wolf City TV. We'll see you next time.
Oh.
You need to holler at Wood. You know it's so good when you log into the Lamar Woodley Show.
You can say what you want to say. It's all good. We're at Kennard Park, getting ready to talk to the Hill Disciples. All the teams made it to the playoff. One is undefeated. We just here to encourage the people. Brought a few of my teammates out, talk to the players, encourage them. Just tell them the importance of how it is working as a team and winning championships. We definitely ought to win championships as Pittsburgh Steelers. Also, I'm going to show the kids how to do the super kick. I want to see them which one of them actually really know how to do the celebration sack kick of Lamar Woodley. So maybe I'll teach them a little something, and maybe they can use it one day when I'm out the game. Maybe. We was going to talk to y'all just a little bit about today about, you know, teamwork and hard work. You know, because last year, as y'all know, we had an opportunity to make it to the Super Bowl, and we lost.
What did we do last year in the championship?
Lost!
So we got something in common with Lamar, huh?
So y'all definitely know that feeling about, you know, making it all the way and losing it. It ain't a good feeling. But the thing is, y'all got another opportunity this year to go back and this time win it and have a perfect season. And I've been a part of a winning team, and I've been a part of a losing team. And y'all have been a part of a losing team as well. So now it's time to be a part of a winning team. But y'all continue to go out there playing hard, playing together, and go out there and get that ring. Well, get the trophy. Work hard. Listen to your coaches. You know, it's a reason y'all 10-0. It's a reason. Or 11-0. Because y'all continue to work hard. And y'all out here running every day while some of y'all friends are sitting at home watching TV. So y'all just continue to work hard, and y'all will go out there, and y'all will get that trophy. So when I get a sack, can somebody show me what I do after I get a sack? Do anybody know?
I do.
What? Let me see. Come on, let me see.
Remember whistle?
Oh. There we go. All right, that was close. I was wondering. It's called my little super kick.
You gotta really just.